Dear children, today let us study about domestic electric circuit. So what electric circuit is been connected at our home? So as you all know, electric power is generated at the power generating station, which are usually located very far away from the areas where it is consumed. Okay, at the generating station, the electric power is generated at 11 kilowatt, because generation at voltage higher than 11 kilowatt causes insulation difficulties, while generation at lower voltage involves high current. So the voltage generated is alternating current of frequency 50 hertz. So to supply this electric power to a house from the city substation, either the overhead wires or cables on poles or an underground cables are used. So they supply this electric wires reach our home through main supply. So there are different cables for that. Okay, so the cable has three wires. The first is the live wire, and the next is the neutral wire, and the third is the earth wire. So the neutral and the earth wires are connected together at the local substation, so that the neutral and earth wires are at the same potential. Neutral wire and earth wire are at the same potential, that is 0 volt. Okay. The live wire, also called the phase wire, which carries current from the source to the distribution board, while the neutral wire is for the return path of the current. So, before connecting the cable from the pole to the meter in a house, first a fuse of high rating is connected in the live wire at the pole. This fuse is called the company fuse, or it is the pole fuse, which is fixed at the electric pole. Okay. So, only this electric supply company person are authorized to handle that pole fuse. The rating of this fuse depends on the load for which connection is taken from the company. After the company fuse, the cable is connected to the kilowatt hour meter, which is usually mounted on the front or outside wall of the house. From the meter, connection are made to the main switch and to the main fuse. The main switch is connected to the live and neutral wires both, while the main fuse is connected in the live wire only. Okay, so let us see now how this electric circuit is connected in our homes. You can see here where the red insulation, the live wire, it is the red color insulation. It is called the live wire, also it is called a phase wire, where it is having a potential of 220 volt. Red color insulation, you can see here, it is a live wire, and the black wire is the neutral wire. Okay, so the neutral wire, it is of black color insulation, it is called neutral wire. Okay, so where it is having 0 volt, and also earth wire is a green color wire, where it is connected to the metal appliances, metal case of the appliances. Okay, so later I will tell what is the function of it. So neutral wire black, live wire red, and earth wire is having green insulation. So how it is taken, let us see, from the pole. So now from the pole, it is carried to the main supply, right? So this wire pass into electricity meter through a main fuse or an MCB. It is called as miniature circuit breaker. So from main switch, they are connected line wire in the house. This wire supply electricity to different circuits in our house. Okay. This is how the domestic electric circuit, that is the circuit in our home, look like. So you can see the live and neutral wire. It is electricity board fuse is here. Next, it is connected to the electric meter board at our homes, which will be outside. And later it is connected to the distribution box, or MCB it is called as, where from this there is a separate fuse for each circuit. and later it is connected, just taken to the different rooms of our home. Okay, where this is the way of connecting. Here the live wire with red insulation cover is positive, and negative wire, the negative is the neutral wire, and earth wire is having green insulation cover. So the potential difference between live and neutral is, in India it is 220 volt. Okay, 220 volt. It is having a frequency of 50 hertz. So this is how the domestic electric circuit looks. Okay, so here now let us see which are the circuits. So normally these two circuits are used, that is 15 ampere current rating circuit, where they are used for appliances having higher load, like electric iron, geyser, where it requires high current. So the current rating is 15 ampere. In the same way, the circuit of 5 ampere current rating is used, where it is used for appliances having less load, like tube lights, TV, bulbs, etc. Okay. So current rating of 5 ampere is for the device which is consuming less current, and the device which consumes more current, more voltage is required, for that the 15 ampere current rating circuit is used. So now different sockets in a switch, let us see. So you may have seen this socket at your home, where it is having three connections. There will be three holes in a socket, right? The upper one bigger hole, and the below two holes will be there. You can observe the socket where the plugs are being inserted, 3-pin socket we call it as. So the below two is for live wire and black is for neutral wire, and the above, which is one little bit bigger than the two live and neutral wire socket, is the earth wire. It is for earth connection. Okay, so what is earth wire? Why it is used? Why this connection is to be done? So one end of the earth wire is buried in the earth, and the other end is connected to the metal casing of the electric appliances by using 3-pin plug. Okay, where the device which is having consuming heavy current, for that earthing is done, and we are using 3-pin plug for that. You can observe the refrigerator is having 3-pin plug, and if you see the washing machine is having 3-pin plug, and oven is having 3-pin plug, geysers are having 3-pin plug. Why this 3-pin plug is used there? Because where the earth connection is required, where it is having high current. So one end of this earth wire is buried in the earth, is deep in the earth, and the other end is connected to the metal casing of the electrical appliances. Okay, so if by chance live wire touches any metal case part of the appliances, what happens? Then the current which is passed into that metal case is directly buried inside the earth, that passes directly to the earth, where it protects us from danger. So this wire has green color insulation, hence earth wire is used to prevent people from getting electric shock. That is, when the metal cases comes direct contact with the electric current, when it touches the live wire, the current which is flowing in that metal case is directly passed through the to the earth. So you can see here how this is done. So you can see here three pin sockets. So this is a 3-pin sockets. So earth wire, here it is a red insulation live wire, and this side is the neutral wire. So you can see it at your home also, 3-pin plugs will be, the sockets are there, where upper is the earth wire connection, this side live, and this side is, it is neutral. Okay, so from the pole fuse it is connected to the electric meter. Here you can see the live and neutral wire which comes from the pole fuse. Later at our home, at our house, the earthing is done. So that is, from the electric meter the earth wire is taken, and it is just buried inside the earth. Okay, so here you can see it is the grounding, that means it is put inside the ground. So where this is the earth wire, so this earth wire, the from the electric meter, it is connected to the upper socket, a hole of the upper socket pin. Okay, so where it is earth connection. So it is connected to the metal case. This connection is done to the electric devices of the metal cases. And later the live and neutral, which is passing through the distribution box with the main switch and fuse, each circuit is having a different fuse. So this is how the electric circuit, this appliance is having metal body like electric iron, then refrigerators, etc. Their metallic body is connected to the earth wire, so that if there is any leakage of current, it passes to the earth and it prevents us from electric shock. Okay, so this is how the domestic circuit is done at our home. So now, what is overloading? Sometimes you may have seen there are number of plugs which is used, right? So you can see here it is overloaded with the plug, right? So what is overloading? So what happens when this is done like this? So if too many electrical appliances are used simultaneously together, so many electric devices are used, so or too many electrical appliances are connected to the same socket, you can see here, they draw extremely large current from the circuit, right? So here there are more current which is utilized, right? So due to this, the wires may get overheated and fire may start. So it gets overheated when so many plugs are connected to the socket. So what happens? It gets overheated. So due to this, the wires may get overheated and fire may start. This is called as overloading. Understood? So what is overloading? It when the electrical, too many electrical appliances used simultaneously, what happens? They draw extremely large current from the circuit. So due to which the wire may get overheated. So this is overloading. So then due to this, there may be a fire. We call it as short circuit. So what is short circuit? So when the live wire and the neutral wire comes into contact, what happens? The short circuit occurs. So actually the live wire is having, which is used for carrying electric current, and neutral wire is used for carrying the back current, okay, to make the circuit complete. We want the closed circuit, right? So the from the electric main, which is going to the bulb, that is the live wire, and the from the bulb again to the electric meter, it is the neutral wire. So neutral wire is used for the backflow of the current, okay, so to make the electric circuit complete. So when this neutral wire and the live wire comes into contact, what happens? There is a spark produced. So this is called as short circuit. So wire crossing is been it happens. So when the insulation is gone of the live wire and neutral wire, so that time also what happens? Short circuit occur. So when live wire and neutral wire comes in direct contact with each other, they cause short circuit. Okay, so when it happens, it happens when the insulation of both the wires get torn. Okay, so current flows through this wire without much resistance. Due to high current passing through this wire, the wire may get heated up and may catch fire. Okay, so this is about short circuit. How to prevent this short circuit? So it can be prevented by using a fuse. So if there is a short circuit, so we can prevent the damage caused by the short circuit by using a fuse. Already you all have studied about electric fuse, right? So let us recall it. So what is fuse? Why it is used? Fuse is a device which is used in a electric circuit. It is a safety device, right? So it prevents damage to the appliances and the circuit due to overloading. So when there is a overloading or when there is a short circuit, what happens? Abruptly more amount of current flows in the circuit, due to which it stops the flow of high electric current. So where the fuse gets off, suddenly the fuse wire breaks off, right? The fuse wire breaks off when the high current flows in that fuse wire, right? So due to which the electric circuit breaks off in the fuse, which prevents the short circuit and overloading. So this is the picture of an electric fuse where it is made up of a porcelain. Okay, here you can see this is a fuse holder where the live wire and the where the live wire, the fuse wire is of the live wire, only one wire, single wire is passed into that fuse, which is a live wire. Okay, so fuse wire, here you can see there is a grip for it, fuse holder it is. So what happens when there is a high current, the fuse wire melts and breaks the circuit. So when it melts, what happens? There is no passing of electric current. Always the fuse wire is of the live wire. Okay, live wire is connected, only the live wire has to be passed through the electric fuse. So when there is a high current, what happens? Fuse wire melts off and it breaks the circuit, which prevents us from damage of the electric circuit. Nowadays, instead of fuse wire, electric fuse, miniature circuit breakers are used. So what is this miniature circuit breaker? I hope you have seen at your home, at your near your electric board, this kind of circuit is been used. So it is called as MCB. Okay, it is full form is miniature circuit breaker. So if a current becomes too large, MCB puts off a switch breaking off power supply. This can be switched on again and it can be reused. Olden days, their fuse was used, where what happens when the what is the disadvantage of fuse is that, so when there is a high current, what happens? The fuse wire gets melted off and again we have to change that fuse wire and we have to use the electric circuit. But in place of that fuse wire, if the miniature circuit breaker, if it is used, what happens? If the high current is passed, what happens? MCB puts off the switch. You can see here the black color switch. So what happens? It falls down as the high current is passed. Automatically it comes down, okay, where it breaks off the power supply when the high current flows in the circuit. So instead of melting in a fuse, here this automatically this black color switch gets off when the high current is passing through it. So this can be switched on again after when it is corrected. It can be reused again by switching it on. When we plug this up, it is switched on again, right? So here when there is a overloading, so after reducing the overload, we can switch on again this miniature circuit breaker. But fuse wire we have to be changing, so that is the disadvantage. Nowadays the modern homes, there is a miniature circuit breakers which are used. So what is the difference between miniature circuit breaker and fuse? So fuse is of the older technology and MCB is the new technology. Here fuse, it cannot be reused, we have to change the wire and we have to plug again. But MCB, this can be reused by switching on again. Okay, so it is now not used, fuse is not used nowadays. But here MCB in place of fuse, the MCB is used in our in modern homes. Okay, but the function is same, both fuse and MCB function is same, but working if it's different. It works on the principle of heating effect of electric current. Fuse is working on the principle of heating effect of electric current. That means as the fuse wire gets heated up, what happens? It breaks off the circuit. But MCB, it works on the principle of magnetic effect of electric current. So where magnetic effect of electric current, you have studied about magnetic effect of electric current, how it works. So that principle is used in MCB. There is a strong magnet in between, so where it makes the switch to, as the high current flows, what happens? It it plugs off the circuit. So this is the main difference between miniature circuit breaker and fuse. Okay, so which are the safety device we have learnt now? Electric fuse is a safety device, earth wire is a safety device, and miniature circuit breaker is a safety devices which we have learnt. So once again, let us recall that, what is electric fuse? Electric fuse is a safety device, right, which is used in the electric circuit to protect the circuit and appliances from damage. So due to overloading and short circuit, whatever damage is caused, that damage is been protected with by using the electric fuse in a circuit. Okay, so it is a wire having high resistance and low melting point. So if excess current flow through this circuit, what happens? The fuse wire melts and it breaks the circuit. So this fuse wire is made up of a metal or an alloy of metal like lead and tin or aluminium and copper. Fuse wire is connected in series with the live wire. Always the live wire connection is done. This fuse should be in series with the electrical appliances. So as the fuse melts, the electrical appliances are not able to work, okay, due to which it breaks off the electric circuit. So this is the function of electric fuse. Nowadays, instead of electric fuse, miniature circuit breakers are used. So next, we had studied about overloading. So what is overloading? How it is caused? Overloading is caused due to increase in voltage. If live wire and neutral wire comes in contact, or if too many appliances are connected to a single socket, right? Or a neutral wire or a live wire comes in contact. So what happens? It results in overheating of the wires. So when there is overheating, it causes a damage to the circuit and appliances. So this overheating of the wires is called as overloading. Okay. So what is short circuit? So this happens, it is caused when live wire and neutral wire comes in direct contact. So when the insulation is gone, what happens? The live wire and neutral wire comes in contact, due to which the spark is produced. So what happens? The current suddenly increases in the circuit. It causes the spark or fire and damage to the circuit and appliances. So this is called as short circuit. So these are the electric fuse, MCB and earth wire. Earthing is done to prevent electric shock. So these are the safety devices which is used in the domestic electric circuit. I hope you all have understood about overloading, short circuit and the safety devices, why it is used in the electric circuit. Right? I hope you all have understood. Thank you. If you have any doubts, you can ask.